It's day two of the competition, and after returning to his normal colour, Robin's got a job on his hands to convince his guests with tonight's food.
I dread to think what Robin's dinner party's going to be like, to be honest.
If he goes with what lorry drivers would be able to eat and cook, we're going to get burger and chips.
I don't think they expect me to be any good at cooking. It's as simple as that. But I will surprise them. They'll be shocked.
Well, if the food doesn't shock them, there's always Claire to fall back on.
Last night, I wasn't as loud as I normally am, but I think that was the nerves. But really looking forward to the rest of the week, because now I can be me.
Be afraid, everybody. Robin's first job of the day is his starter. Mushrooms stuffed with bacon, spinach and onion.
Spinach. Blah. No, don't like spinach.
I love stuffed mushrooms myself, but I do tend to stuff them with a little bit more imaginative ingredients.
He begins by frying together onion, bacon, garlic and spinach. Once cooled, Robin adds cream to the mixture.
Fill it with cream. Everybody likes cream. It's beautiful.
Yep, can't beat a bit of cream. He fills his mushrooms with the creamy mix and will top with cheese before baking later tonight. Next, Robin's main. Chicken with York ham, Stilton cheese, shallots and beetroot.
I love Stilton cheese.
If he puts too much Stilton in that chicken, it's going to overpower in it and it will be nasty.
Robin rolls Stilton cheese in ham before placing the parcel inside a chicken breast with a sprig of sage. The whole thing is wrapped in bacon.
The taste to it is superb.
Solid mental attitude.
Of course I'm confident. I am the winner.
He'll cook the rest later once the guests are here. Finally, dessert. Chocolate fondant with summer berries, fruit puree and cream.
I'd probably expect to find this at, like, a six-year-old's birthday party.
What happened to jelly and ice cream?
If it's overcooked, it's just going to be a sponge. And if it's undercooked, it's not going to be nice.
It's one of the hardest desserts you could do, and if they appreciate that and it's done properly, they must give me top marks for it.
For his difficult dessert, Robin melts chocolate with butter, whisks together sugar, eggs and flour, before adding vanilla extract and the chocolate. He then lines his ramekins.
The hardest part about it all is getting the chocolate itself out of the ramekins once it's done.
The mixture is poured in and a piece of chocolate placed in the centre of each one. Robin's fondants will be warmed through prior to serving.
Right, I've just got time. Give me face a wash and bits a wash.
Get everywhere, that chocolate. Robin rushes off to do what he's got to do before the arrival of his guests. First in, it's keen caravaner Richard.
Richard,
hello.
Man.
Nice to see you.
Normal colour.
Yeah, the green has gone.
Look a lot better.
Yes, you
recognise that.
Yeah, you look younger.
No, behave yourself. Next to arrive is Carly.
Hello.
Good evening, dear. Are you all right?
Yeah,
nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Again.
So glad I could kiss you tonight. We're being green.
Bet she's not, though. Last in, it's talkative learning mentor Claire.
Hello, Claire.
Who
nice
are
to
you?
See
you're
you again.
Not green.
Bit green. Come on in, please.
Oh, you look really nice.
How are you?
They knew the change. There was a change to the man. The green paint had gone. The face was out. 55. Not bad, am I?
Robin adds the final touches to his starter.
I've got to get this bag on. If I fail, I lose, and I'm not going to lose.
And here it is. Mushrooms stuffed with bacon, spinach and onion. Doesn't look promising.
Claire, don't you like that filling, then?
I don't like spinach.
See, that's it.
You take sorry.
No, that's fine. It's just it's nice lovely. To know why you don't like it. You know what I mean? So if you don't like spinach, you don't like it.
I love you as a person, but I know like your starter.
The filling that is the main part of the mushroom, she just didn't even try. I didn't like one or two of her things last night, but I had a bash at it.
This is really, really nice.
Good.
For a lorry driver, he's done pretty well with a stuffed mushroom, definitely.
There's a compliment in there somewhere. Back at the table, Claire reveals there is some stuffing she would like done.
Go for it. Yeah. Do you know what? If I had the money, I'd have bigger
boobs. No,
I'd have a facelift.
No.
My God, I'd have the bloody look.
Wait a minute, Claire. The youngest person on the table, what do you personally think about it? Everything that you've got will be standing where it is.
Delicately put.
Kiss me, so is mine.
No, but
thank
not,
you very
I'm
much.
I'm not being disrespectful.
No, so is mine.
I think you might have to speak up, Carly.
Mine is an all.
Mine are standing where they are because I paid $4,000 to get them to stand.
I get you. Woohoo! Good
and
girl. I don't
still,
blame you.
Better still.
Let her speak. Let her speak.
Good girl.
The loudness of Claire's voice is starting now to just grate on me a little bit.
You and me both.
I've only got one pair of ears, and preferably I don't really want a hearing aid in my 20s.
I guess there's only so much plastic a girl can take. Time for the main. Having cooked his chicken in stock, Robin pops it under the grill. He'll use the remaining juice to make his gravy, or at least try to.
Not thick, no, why? Come on, why?
Don't ask me, it's your recipe. In goes more flour.
Struggling, it's really, really struggling. Mm.
No time for twirling, man, your guests are hungry.
There's an awful lot of noise coming from there, though.
I can smell the sweat that's dripping down.
I can smell...
What's happening?
Your gravy's not thickening.
Something must have gone wrong.
It's about to get worse.
It's just congealed. Oh, God, I've kept it all out. I don't believe it. Instead of pouring it through a strainer into a pot, I poured it down the sink.
Yes, we saw. It does look a bit thicker, though.
I'm going to do this chicken casserole mix. You'll not know no difference.
If you'd like to know how to rescue a meal once the gravy's gone down the sink, log on to the Channel 4 website, where you can download this week's recipes in your own online scrapbook.
God, what have I done? You're supposed to put the water in second.
Oh, dear. Plan C.
Onion.
Onion it is, then.
How do you go wrong with chicken?
By serving it with a badly made onion gravy.
I've totally f***ed it up. I'll have to do without gravy. I'm gutted.
Oh, well, at least you tried. One very dry chicken with York ham and Stilton cheese.
Where's
the gravy?
Where's the sauce?
Have we got any yet?
I'll settle for a bit of water if that's...
You'll just have to struggle along.
No,
I'm sorry.
Listen.
I am very, very sorry.
Listen.
That's fine.
It's just a total nightmare.
The chicken was so dry. It was just totally disastrous. Oh, my God. No.
I can see that there was potential.
Potential, yeah. Is that the word, Richard?
Yeah.
Potential.
Yeah. Robin wanted to make the perfect dinner party, and unfortunately, it failed, and it failed big time.
You've got to laugh about these things. I messed all the chicken up, but I like all, you know, Roy Chubby Brown and all that gets me
hey?
Creased up. I hate up. Chubby Brown.
You don't like him?
No, I hate Chubby Brown.
You don't like him?
No, oh, I think he's Chubby amazing. Brown.
But what's he got to do with your gravy?
Oh, it's how Northerners talk. I talk like that. I eff and blind all the time.
Yeah, we'd noticed.
Oh, but doesn't it show your ignorance that you have to use a swear word rather than using a proper word?
I disagree. All it is to to make it a little bit funnier, to express it
I
a bit.
I don't agree.
That is my opinion. You have children maybe at school that maybe don't swear. They maybe, but as soon as they get outside, your classroom, that's what kids are like.
I'm telling you. If they respect me as a teacher... Okay,
in your classroom.
Take it out of the classroom and they will go...
No, they do.
You
think they do.
No, you're not.
Claire just shocked me a little bit tonight. She's...
incredibly loud.
She'll not let you get a word in edgeways, and I lost it a little bit weird tonight.
You don't need to use swear language. If you're using it, it's not very good. It shows your lack of...
intelligence.
Intellectual. Oh, God, that's not good.
No. But with any luck, Robin's next offering will be... language!
I can win it with this course. Get in! That's what you call cooking.
That's what I call ice skating. Here it is, chocolate fondant. And in an attempt to salvage his evening, Robin's decided to tell a joke. Keep it clean.
There's two pieces of tarmac stood at bar. There's a piece from M6 and a piece from M1.
God, no, so
and he goes, well, I'm M6. Busiest traffic you will ever have. Anyway, when he's saying that, M1 went really quiet. He goes, what's the matter with you, mate? He says, there's a red piece of tarmac walking past us. He says, why on the right, yeah? He says, it's a cycle path.
Anyone? Cycle path, bit like psychopath.
So it's not just chicken that you f***ed out there?
Looks that way. Taxi!
Robinson's jokes are as bad as his cooking, but I can't help but love him. But his cooking is...
Tonight, the starter was great. The main was a letdown, and I'm not a pudding guy. So for that, he gets a 5.
He definitely lost the plot in the kitchen with the main course, so I'm going to have to give him a 5.
I'm really sorry, Robin. It's a 5.
Giving Robin a far from impressive 15 points. Kind of leaves a really dry taste in your mouth.
Gravy. Gravy let me down.
I don't think there's any competition at all, and I think I'm definitely going to pull it out of the bag.
They'd be nice with a bit of gravy too.
Coming up!
Oh, wow! Oh,
no. Dressing up!